The subtract system. In it, we have discussed already about the blood vessels as well as the structure of the blood, blood cells, and also functions of the subtract system, and also the functions of the blood. Today, we are going to discuss about the blood groups. You might be experienced about somebody of your relatives is saying about that his blood group is B positive, some other person A positive, O positive, O negative, like a different variety of blood groups. How, if you take a pin and pinch or prick into the body, you will get the blood, and the blood you see that it is a red in color and it will be the same for everyone. But when you go for the diagnosis or testing of the blood, you will come to know that the blood groups. Who made these blood groups? In what basis the blood has been grouped? That we are going to discuss. Actually, blood is very important for us. And also, if somebody has met an accident, he needs a lot of blood. Then the doctor suggests anyone donate the blood or bring the blood. Usually the person who met an accident, his blood group is A positive. Think of, imagine. Okay, so the patient who needs the blood, otherwise who receives the blood from the others, is a nothing but a recipient. The person who receives the blood from the others, is called as a recipient. And you might be in your locality or in your relatives, somebody has the A positive and he is ready to give the blood. Such a person, the person who is donating the blood is nothing but called as a donor. The person who is donating the blood is called as a donor. So he is also having the A positive blood. So the recipient is having the A positive blood and the donor also having the A positive blood. So then the blood from the donor is collected by the doctor and it is transfused into the recipient. For example, if the recipient is having the A positive blood, and the donor is not having the A positive and maybe he is having the B positive blood. What happens if this B positive blood is transfused to the A positive blood group person? And automatically, when B positive blood means other group of blood is transfused to the recipient, immediately it will become incompatible and coagulation will be taking place and clumpings will be occur, the person may die. So that's why compulsorily the person who donates the blood to the recipient, compulsory same blood group, the blood group should be matched, the same blood group should be donated. And blood transfusion, it is nothing but injecting the blood through the veins of the recipient, is called as a transfusion, blood transfusion. It is necessary for the recipient, for the person who met an accident. Okay. And here, before the blood transfusion, the blood which is taken from the donor should be tested for HIV or any other chronic diseases, or they are not in the blood, or affected by the donor or not. If it is affected by any kind of chronic diseases, what I mentioned there, like HIV, cancer, such type of things, such type of disease. Such type of blood should not be transfused to the recipient, because along with this blood, those diseases also will, disease causing germs also will be enter into the recipient. Soon after, the recipient also will be affected by such kind of diseases. That's why the blood group, the before the blood transfusion, the blood should be thoroughly checked by the doctor, and then it is transfused to the recipient. Okay, so this A positive, B positive, like the different variety of groups of blood are there. But among those all, actually who discovered or who invented this type of blood groups? Who gave these names, A positive, B positive? Actually, what is this? That we are going to discuss. Okay. In the year 1900, Karl Landsteiner, was the scientist who gave the first of the blood groups. Karl Landsteiner. Okay, and he has given the a system of ABO system. ABO system. Okay, and according to him, there are four types of blood groups: A group, B group, AB group, and O group. They are the blood groups: A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group, and then the O blood. According to the Karl Landsteiner. And there are lot of different variety of blood groups are there, but among all those systems, blood group systems, ABO blood group system and RH blood group system are the most famous blood groups systems. Okay, and what basis this Karl Landsteiner has given the blood groups? Actually, in the human body, in the human blood, in fact, in the human blood, there are two types of factors will be presented. One is antigen. Another one is antibody. Antigen, antibody. These antigens are presented on the RBC. The antigens are presented on the RBC, and antibodies are present on the plasma of the blood. Antibodies present in the plasma of the blood. There are two antigens, two types of antigens are there, that is A and B. A and B antigens are presented, and they are indicated with small letters of the alphabets, A and B. And there are complementary antibodies also presented there, and they are indicated with capital letters A and B. It means that if the antigen A is presented in a blood, and further a complementary antibody B will be presented there in the plasma. Once again, I repeat that. If the antigen A, the small a, antigen A is presented in the RBC, and then there is a complementary antibody, that is B, will be presented in the plasma of the blood. Okay, let me write here. So here, antigen antibody. Antigen, antibody. antigen A, and antibody B. And B blood group people are having the antigen B and antibody A. And AB blood group people are having the antigen. Little correction, small correction is here. The antigens are indicated with A and B capital letters. Antibodies are small letters. So little small correction. So let me write now. Antigen A, antibody B. Antigen B, antibody A. In the blood group AB, antigen only present. Only antigen will be presented. No antibodies are present here. No antibodies are present here in the AB blood group. And O blood group people, no antigen will be presented, but antibodies are presented here. Antibodies are present. Antibodies are always complementary to the antigens. Okay, A blood group people are having the antigen, capital letter E, antigen, and A, and B antibody will be B. And B blood group people are having the antigen B, and antibody will be A. And AB blood group people are having the only antigens, that is A and B. No antibodies are connected there. Whereas the O blood group people are having the no antigen, but AB antibodies are present in their plasma of the blood. So based on these two factors, that is antigen and antibody, based on these two factors, Karl Landsteiner in the year 1900, the Karl Landsteiner has discovered the blood groups. And according to his system, that is ABO system, there are four blood groups are there. A group, B group, AB group, as well as the O group. Okay. So ABO system will be like this. A group. System, ABO system, ABO system. According to the ABO system, O blood group people can donate the blood to A group, B group, as well as the AB group. And A group people can donate the blood to AB group, A group plus AB group. And B group people can donate the blood to B group plus AB group. So here AB group is only receiving the blood. It cannot donate the blood. It can donate the blood to only AB group. Only AB group people. Not for all the group people. So that AB group people are called as universal recipients. So the AB group is called as universal recipient group. Universal recipient blood group. Which one? AB group. And O group is called as universal donor. Universal donor. O group people are called universal donors. AB group people are called as universal recipient. Why? Because O group people can donate the blood to A group. O group people can donate the blood to O group, A group, AB group, even to the B group. But A group people can donate the blood to A group plus AB group. And B group people can donate the blood to B group plus AB. And AB group can receive the blood from all the groups. So that's why AB group people are called as universal recipients, and O group people are called as universal donors. Suppose if the A group people receive the blood from B group people, what happens? Let us So A group people can donate the blood to A group plus AB group. They cannot donate the blood to the B group as well as the O group. And B group people can donate the blood to B group as well as AB group. They cannot donate the blood to the A group as well as the O group. AB group people cannot donate the blood to A group, B group, but they can donate the blood to the AB group, and they cannot donate the blood to the O group. And O group people can donate the blood to all the groups. Can donate the blood to the all the groups. That's why AB group people are called as universal recipients. Universal recipients, and O group people are called as universal donors. AB group people are called as universal recipients, and O group people are called as universal donors. Suppose if A group people are donate the blood to the B group people, what happens? That I will tell you. Look at the board. A group people are having the antigen A, antibody B, and B group people are having the antigen B and antibody A. Suppose if the A group people donate the blood to the B group people, the antigen A and antigen antibody A will be coagulated, clotting will be taking place, and clumpings are occurring. Clumpings means the blood will be completely become blisters like structures, balls like structures. So that's why, and also antigen B and antibody B will be clumped each other, so that the blood will be completely clotted, and the person who received the blood, the person will die. The recipient will be dying. So that's why A group people can donate the blood to the A group people and the AB group people. B group people can donate the blood to the B group as well as the AB group. And AB group people can donate the blood to only AB group people only, not for all the groups. But O group people can donate the blood to all other four groups, all other three groups. So AB group people are called as universal recipients, and O group people are called as universal donors. Okay, I think you have understood this topic. Now let us move to the orange system. Okay. If the RH factor is present, then RH positive, it is called as RH positive blood group. If the RH factor is absent or not present, then it is called as RH negative. So based on the RH presence of the RH factor in the blood groups are like A positive, A negative, B positive, B negative, AB positive, AB negative, O positive, O negative. This way the total blood groups have been classified. A positive means RH factor is present. B negative means RH factor is absent. What happens if the RH factor is present? RH factor is absent. Let me explain. Suppose if the RH factor is present in the blood group people are having the antigen D, antigen D in their RBC. If the RH factor is present in the blood groups of any blood group, those people are having the antigen D extra in their RBC. So this will play an important role here now. Suppose a woman with the RH positive, RH negative, a woman with RH negative is married with a man RH positive. Okay. In the first pregnancy, the fetus develops the antibodies against the RH negative, against the RH negative, because the fetus will also get the RH positive factor in the its blood. So it develops the RH negative, RH antibodies for the RH negative. So in the first pregnancy after the child birth also the child will not be affected, but the mother body is having the antibodies for RH negative. Okay, and then what happened in the second pregnancy, soon after the first birth, in the second pregnancy once again the baby will be developing the antibodies for RH negative, so that it will be affected to the fetus which is developing in the womb of the mother. In the womb of the mother, the fetus will be die automatically because of the incompatibility of the antibodies as well as the antigens. This kind of condition is called as erythropoietic photolysis. The red blood cells will be completely destroyed by these antibodies, and then the fetus, that means the baby in the womb of the mother, will die because of the RH This is the one condition. First baby will not be dead, but second baby, soon after, immediately, if the mother or if the woman is having pregnancy, soon after the first birth, immediately the second baby will be dying. This is called erythropoietic. The condition of situation is called as erythropoietic. Okay. And next, this is the one example because of the RH pair. And another one. If a recipient is having the Rh negative blood group and he has met an accident, he needs the blood, and if the donor having the Rh positive blood and is donated to the recipient, and the first time the recipient will develop the antibodies against the Rh positive. If it is continued for second time, third time, fourth time, the antibodies about the Rh positive will be increased, the fight with the Rh negative, and the recipient will die soon. This is also will be happening because of the Rh pair. So that the recipient is having the Rh negative, so that the donor also should have the Rh negative here. So then the compatibility will be taking place, and the person will not be dying because of the Rh factor. So this is a complete information about the blood groups, ABO system, as well as the Rh system. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the structure of human heart, very, very important organ of the circulatory system.